Hey folks, welcome back. Chris Garlock here with Michael Redmond, nine Don professional for our latest AlphaGo versus the world. Hope you're enjoying this series. Michael, we're just going to jump right into it. I'm going to let you pronounce our player's name today. I think I mangled it when I was...
Okay, it's Tuo Jiaxi.
Oh, nice. All right.
He was born in 1991, so he's in his early 20s at the time of this game. And he won the LG tournament. So that was in 2014. So he's already a world champion.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's Heilongjiang. He's from Heilongjiang. I probably shouldn't have said that because I probably mangled it, but it's northern China.
Okay, we can do that. Yeah. All right, let's see how he does.
So AlphaGo has black, and you might notice something already because I've been talking all the time about how AlphaGo likes to play a star point and then a 3-4 point.
Mm-hmm.
I guess it got bored or something.
Whoa, 2-3-4 points. Have we ever seen this? I was just sort of getting so used to that same opening.
Same opening so many times. And like, I was thinking maybe it was just the human player had to change it in order to get a new opening, but it wasn't so. It turns out AlphaGo plays various openings in this version. Like, later on, I did see some repetition, but at this point, it is playing the same, playing various openings, and it plays moves without being prodded to do so. It plays different moves. So it plays 2-3-4 points, and it plays a Kakari. So it looks like black might be even, if it was a human player, black would be heading towards the mini Chinese opening. So white plays here, and the game actually AlphaGo plays here after all. So it still likes this corner enclosure. This is a position where a human player would, for instance, old style would be to play this Chinese opening. And at the time of this game, already people were playing this, had been playing this one for a while. So it's one of these two points, which were very popular and sort of reminiscent, actually. There was an opening that Hoinbo Dosaku played 300 years ago, which was very similar to this. And he did not play the corner enclosure, because he felt that when he was playing a handicap game with white, sometimes he would play something like this and try to get into a fight in the upper left corner.
Mm.
So it's an idea that has been around a long time, but computer programs do not play this move very much. Actually, they prefer to play some kind of a shimari. I think most modern players would prefer the big shimari here, actually. This is the more popular one.
It feels more active, doesn't it?
Excuse me?
Feels a bit more active when it's up high like that.
It's more active, and there is the fact that at some point white's going to play an attachment here, which we did not know about at the time. So maybe there's no weakness there. We just didn't know that move. So white plays, and this looks so much like this is a human move, actually, but it looks like a human opening on the whole.
Mm-hmm.
This is something that I could probably find in one of my own games.
Mm.
Because I have played early approach moves like this myself, and I do like this shimari. So actually, I think this is an opening that I've played. I could probably find you an identical board position.
Cool.
But this is when already computer programs want white to play this move. And since I have talked about this in a number of these games, I'll just show you the order of moves. This is a joseki that I sort of like, and white's follow-up move would be an extension on the side. And this is what I was coming up with. And it looks, this is a more active way for white to play. It does take a stronger control of the upper side with this extra stone here added on. So white's getting more space on the upper side. And in return, black is getting a stronger position in the corner. So it's arguably an even trade, but it turns out that the game in which black gets to extend here, it is a bit uncomfortable for white, in that white does have to deal with that group there. White jumps. This was the joseki at the time. Also, this is a move that actually human players were also playing. And it gets really complicated when black pokes out here.
Yeah.
Like this. It's just white has ideas of jumping here next, and just reducing the value of everything that's going to happen on the upper side. And so white's not taking care of the upper side in the fashion that humans usually do, but is trying to make it less important. and trying to switch to the lower half of the board where white does have an advantage. It's a more active way of playing, and I like this way of playing actually. In the game, white just plays here. And locally, you would see, usually you would see black playing something like this or something like this. But instead, AlphaGo plays from the side of his moyo. This also looks, it's a move that would occur to me. It's a very nice looking move that does increase black's potential in this whole kind of drawing a line like this, imaginary line to where black wants to make territory. And like this. This move is threatening to invade next, and white actually answers it. White, and I don't really get this move, but this is where Lila wants to play. Just like that. And white's just going to ignore everything that happens on the upper side. So it doesn't matter, apparently.
Okay.
And I don't really see why this is, well, it's a more exciting way to play. I don't really see myself as being happy in this opening with white. But
certainly
it does
not get a better winning percentage. Certainly you would not be very comfortable, I'll say that.
When black plays here, black's winning percentage is at 56%. So that's just a very slight gain for black because at 6.5 point Komi, black does start at something like 53, 54, somewhere around there. So 56% is a slight advantage for black. It's more than 8 points. So it's maybe 1.5 point win for black, if you believe the computer. White answers and black plays here. And this is sort of strange because master is black and is playing an extension towards the side. I don't think this is where computer programs would usually play. They don't like this extension towards the side usually. So like an attachment at this point against the corner would be commonly played. It's a bit unusual the way AlphaGo is playing here. And this is an important point. In the game, white played here and black extended from the side. And at this point, white's going to lose some points. At this point, it's more like, let's see. Oh, it's still okay. But white should have played, it's still in the 50s.
Right.
But white should have played sideways like this. Just getting a bit of a base. Like if black plays here, then white can play a large, nice move here. Or if black plays something from above, then white can always play another extension here. And white will have a base on the side. So that will make it so much easier for white to live there. And this extension here on the side, although it's a very narrow extension, it is looking at the weak point. The point I've marked at C15 is one of the weak points in black's corner enclosure there. It's something that white can aim at later in the game. So this would have been okay for white still. In the game, when white jumps here and black extends, it is getting slightly bad for white. White plays around here. This is where white should have simply surrounded the black stone.
I was just going to ask. Just take the cash, right?
Yeah. Well, black still does have this potential connection underneath here, and so it's not completely captured. But it's just that much safer for white, and white will be able to maybe set up an attack on the lower side with an invasion here next. It's just that much more control. And again, I think it's an issue of control. The fact that black does have that mark point where black can try to connect underneath, but then white will play here. You can see that since white's stones are loosely connected here, it's giving white a measure of control in the fights that will be coming up. Now, control is very important for AlphaGo and the following computer programs too. It's important for humans too, but we worry about territory a bit more than computers do. And, you know, this fight that white is about to start in the upper side is going to be very, very tough. And it's a fight that I would not feel very comfortable in, but the computer is suggesting that it's still okay for white. White curls around. White was trying to take away space from black in this general area. But now black plays straight down here. And this is reducing the corner, looking at this weak point at the 3-3 point. At the same time as securing a potential connection underneath. So that's the idea here for black. And we're getting close to 60% for black now. White plays here. It might have been better for white to simply play the attachment here, which basically, at some point, white can peep here and cut black off. So it's setting that up, and then white plays here anyway. And so it's very similar to what was happening before. Black will probably connect underneath. Black can do it. This would be easy. Maybe black's actually going to bump against white here, and this is probably going to work. And then white could probably play away. And so this would be just so much better for white just to forget the left side, give that area to black. And what's funny about this is that white is going to mount a successful invasion. White's going to do something really tactical here. And this move is, locally, it's going to work. And now I'm just going to show you. Black extends here, then white plays here. Now black is going to connect to the corner. And white has to take some responsibility for this stone. Like if white just leaves it, it's going to be a bad exchange that increases black's territory. It still is a good point to play here, but I think when white has played this move already, I think there's a kind of a block. You really want to make that marked stone work. Usually it's a bad idea for white just to abandon that stone like this. So white continues in the corner. The more local success white gets here, the worse the game is going to be. It's going to be counterintuitive because black just allows white to live. Black doesn't even try to kill. Like I could try to kill with a move like this, for instance. It's not going to do that. Black just allows white to live. White gets all these forcing moves, and that's a 10-point territory in the corner. You'd think white should be happy, right?
Yeah.
Nope. Well, first of all, black gets this. This was forcing, so now this territory is looking a lot more solid. At this point in the game, it turns out black has, according to Katago, black has 73%, and that's 50 points before company. That's a big difference. And then black continues like this. And like black's just allowing white to do all this stuff. Black's not even going to try to attack, didn't try to attack white on the upper side, and just playing very peacefully. And so just to show you some more of the game, black doesn't even try to attack this group.
That's simple.
This group is white's weak group. Black doesn't try to attack it. I would try to attack it, but black just surrounds the territory here and very calmly finishes it off the game. Black has all these territories. Again, you can see white's done so much. White was trying to take territory, but did not take enough. And so black is ahead by 15 points.
Black has done everything that white wanted him to do. It's 15 points ahead.
That's right. It's sort of strange, isn't it?
It is very strange. I was going to say it's discouraging. It's like, you know, what's a guy got to do?
Yeah, I think this is actually one of the games that went to the end, but the human player in the end, he resigned. It became fairly close, but you know, AlphaGo does that.
Right.
Something like 10 points on the board in the end, so it was a few points difference. But it reminds me of the time in China when KJ was playing AlphaGo. There was a team game where there were five professionals playing against AlphaGo.
Yeah,
and they were a team. They were consulting and stuff. And like KJ was a bit upset because AlphaGo was so strong. He was having a hard time. But these guys were laughing when they resigned because AlphaGo played this stupid move that like someone placing four stones would not play such a bad move. And they knew that it was just because the game was hopeless for them, that it was just giving them some points back and it was time to resign. So they were laughing when they resigned.
Patting them on their little heads. what an elegant game. This is just a lovely, you know, it's so impressive. So impressive. Really beautiful game. Nice analysis too, Michael. It's cool. All right, folks. Well, we're gonna wrap that up. Again, we will for the book, Michael, of course, will be going into some more variations and so forth. So that's why we're keeping these fairly straightforward and focused. But you'll get more detail in the book. So look forward to that. Thanks as always for watching. See you next time.